What's up, everyone? On this episode, we're preparing for Reefapalooza Orlando, so let's get to it. Woohoo! So in this video, whether you are a coral enthusiast, hobbyist, you're there to take in the show just to see what it's about, or you have a YouTube channel and you want to get video on it, this video is going to cover things that I think are beneficial for you to bring along and also ways of thinking about approaching the show. So that being said, let's get into the video. As of today, it is 7 days until the start of Reefapalooza Orlando. I'm looking really forward to the show because it is the first one I'm attending in Orlando. It is the accommodations is at the Carib Royal Hotel and Convention Center at 8101 World Center Drive in Orlando. Now, the video is basically going to cover what I feel you should bring to a show of this size. First, obviously, a very comfortable pair of shoes because you are going to be standing and doing a lot of walking around. Of course, you're going to bring cash as well as if you have to. Make sure you have your debit card with you because there will be ATMs. I would pick up your tickets online, and you can pick that up right at just do basically a web search for Reefapalooza Orlando, and it'll take you to the website where you can purchase tickets. So that I would do long in advance, or you know, as much as you can. So this way you don't have to wait on the line, the long line to buy tickets as well. When you're at the show, make sure you bring something that's able to keep, if you intend on buying coral, to keep the coral in. A bag such as this, a lunch bag that's lined to keep things warm so you can put your coral in it. And also, you can also pick up at your local food supermarket. These bags are usually sold in the frozen food section. They keep things hot or cold. This way you can keep your coral warm for the trip that you have or whatever. Pick up a towel, bring it in, throw it in the bag. Obviously, it would probably be a little bit bigger than this one, but this is basically to keep your hands dry and also to keep the containers that you buy, such as these. These are basically specimen containers that you can buy on eBay or Amazon. You can ask the vendors if you're making a purchase to use your container to put them in. This way you have a container that's not going to leak. They're very easy to manage as far as getting the top on and off, and you can put them inside whatever you're carrying your coral in, so that they don't bounce around as much. That's why, you know, putting the towel in there helps not only to keep them warm but also to protect the container from bouncing around. Since the show is being held in Orlando, and I did check the weather forecast earlier, and it's going to be in the 80s for that week, you won't have to think about as far as heat packs or what have you for the time that you're there. But if you're traveling to a colder climate, or if you're even mailing them out, and we'll get into that in a little bit, you're going to have to bring heat packs with you or buy heat packs. So this way it keeps everything warm and protected for the trip back to home, or if you're going, like I said, mailing them out. Now, as far as these lunch bags are concerned, it's really great because they do have handles so you can carry them all around the show, and it makes things a lot easier. As far as another thing is, anyone who's purchased coral online will usually have one of these, and these are these big styrofoam, or they come in all different sizes, but they're styrofoam containers that coral is placed in. You may want to carry one of these if you have an extra pair of hands, or even if you put it in your car and keep it for after the show to put your coral purchases in. Now, a good thing to do with this is if you're intending on staying in Florida for a while, you can keep the coral in this, pick it up at the end of the show. Most of the vendors, if you say, I'm going to be purchasing this but not taking it until the end of the show, will hold on to the coral for you. Once you get the coral in your possession and you can put it in one of these containers, you can use these also to ship them out from Florida to your home. If you want, if it's going to be like, you're going to be there for an extra day or what have you. So this way, when you get home, the coral will be there. But also, these styrofoam containers do keep them well protected. You can even put the bags, the thermal bags, right in here. This is a larger one that I have. And you can purchase them online as well. Just look up Kodiak Cooler and you'll be able to find them. A bigger towel probably in here would be the best thing, and that will keep everything well protected. Now also, to think of, if you are a YouTube content creator, there's another set of things that you have to worry about. And that is, before you leave your home for the show, make sure you have your filter for your camera all set up, extra batteries, all the batteries in your audio equipment is kept up. Also, another thing that's good is your cell phone. Don't forget, you don't have to bring a big camera to these shows. You can record everything you need to do on your cell phone with a quality camera on it. Now, another area is your tripod or bipod or whatever you're using to stabilize your camera. Make sure that you have a case for that as well, so this way it doesn't get beat up in your travels. This particular one already had one when I bought it, so I didn't have to worry about that. Along with your kit, all your gear for your camera, there are plenty of bags. This one happens to be a backpack model that everything fits in nice and comfortably. It's easy to access, and all my cables and everything I need for my whole system, my whole kit, is right there. One other thing, extra memory cards. Very important to bring along, so this way you don't run out of memory cards and you're basically sunk at that point. So, as well as if you're a content creator or just taking in the show, snacks, bring snacks, drinks, whatever you need to make this a very enjoyable experience. Like I said, I will be at the show as well, so stop by and say hi. I look forward to meeting you and also taking in the show for the first time in Orlando. And that's basically it for now. So until the next video, this is Scott. I will see you soon around the Reef Tank or in Orlando.
Thank you for watching this episode of Roscoe's Reef with Scott. As always, don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe.